Hello everyone and welcome back to another Blender Made Easy tutorial. Today we're going to be creating dust particles using Blender. In the last tutorial we created this image right here and at the end of it we used Photoshop to create the dust particles and I know some people don't have Photoshop so I thought that I would try to figure out how to do it in Blender. And it's actually pretty simple. The first thing that we're going to do is scale up this cube a little bit and I'll drag it up so it's sitting right on the grid floor. And then I'll press S and Y and scale it along the Y. That's actually a little too tall, so I'll scale that down. And basically what you want to do is add in a bunch of particles inside this cube. To do that, we're going to go over to the particle system and then click new on that. Change the type over to hair. And if we press Z and go into wireframe, you'll notice that nothing is inside. That's because we need to open up the source and change the emit from faces over to volume. Now currently you don't really see anything. That's because we need to add in another object. So press Shift A, we'll add in an icosphere. This is going to be the particle. So select icosphere, and in this panel right here, I'm gonna set the subdivisions down to 1. Because there's going to be quite a lot of particles, I don't want the scene to lag, so setting the subdivisions to 1 will work perfectly fine. And then I'll just drag it over to the right. I also want to scale this inwards just a little bit to make it a little thin. And what you could do is morph this a little bit. So maybe I'll select this vertice, drag it this way, just so it's not completely spherical, something like that. And if you wanted to, you can create multiple of these and put them into a new collection. But for the sake of this tutorial, we'll just use this one. And I'll scale it down even more. Select your cube and then go down to the render settings. Open up the render and select the render as path over to object. And then select your object, which is the icosphere. And there we can see all of our icospheres are now inside our cube. Currently they're way too big, so I'm gonna set the size all the way down to 0.01 and the random size up to 1. I want there to be a lot of randomness, so set that all the way up to 1. Also, turn on advanced so we can change the rotation. Open up the rotation and make sure that is checked. And now let's position the camera. So go into front view by pressing 1 on your number pad. Control Alt 0 to snap the camera into place. Then you can select it and just position it right inside the cube. Make sure it's inside just like that. Now this is a little bit of a tight perspective and I do want to see more of the particles. So go over to your camera settings and I'll just drag this down to about 32 or so. So we just get more of a perspective angle like this. And there we go. So now let's go back over to the settings, go over to the particle system settings. Now to give every single particle a little bit of randomness, what I'm gonna do is zoom in, change the orientation as normal, and then just turn up the randomness. You can also turn up the phase and give the randomness there as well. And every single particle will have a random rotation, and that looks pretty good. All right, the particle system is done. Now, before we get onto the material for our particles, I do want to set up a little bit of volume and some lighting to really show off the particles. So to do that, with the cube selected, I'm gonna go over to the material tab, and then go over to the volume settings and set the volume to the principled volume shader right here. You can go ahead and remove this. You don't really need that principled shader. And for the density, I'm gonna set this to 0.14. Once we do that, we can press Z and go into rendered view, and we can see we have some volume in our scene. Now I am using Eevee right here, so make sure that's the render engine that you're using. And another thing that I'll do is change the world background all the way to black, and then select your point lamp, which is right here, select that point lamp, and then I'm gonna move it over to the left right here. Go over to the lamp settings, and I'm gonna set the power of this to be, let's go with 300. And then for the color, let's give it a nice blue color, something like this. And then I'm gonna press Shift D, and I'll set it to a spot lamp, and I'll rotate the spot lamp this way, and then I'll set the size a little bit lower, something like that, at 29. And then I'll set the strength of this to 1000. Let's go into camera view and see what this looks like. So press 0, then press Z and go into rendered view. And you can toggle overlays. And so here is what our scene is looking like so far. Now to really get some depth of field and some cool effects, let's go ahead and select the camera, turn on depth of field. Now we need to set an object in the middle of our scene to have our camera focus on that. So go back into solid view, and then I'll press shift A, we'll add in an empty object right here, and then I'll just position this in the middle of the scene. So go into wireframe and just position it, let's go into camera view, something like this or so. There we go. And now we'll select our camera, go over to the depth of field, and the focus object will be that empty. Make sure the f-stop is quite low, like a value of 0.2. We'll see what that looks like in the rendered view. And here we can see that's looking pretty cool. I do want there to be a little bit more particles though, so I'll go over to the particle system right here, and I'll set the number to 2000. Let's go back into toggle overlays, and we can see quite a lot of particles now in our scene, and it's starting to look pretty cool. All right, so basically what we need to do for the material for the particle is I'll select my particle right here, select that icosphere. We'll go back into camera view and then click on new. Now currently you can see some shadows on the particles and it's okay, it looks decent, but I don't really want to see any shadows right there. I want it to just be kind of just a speck in the 3D space. So what I'm gonna do is click new on the material. And for the emission, I'll just drag that up just slightly. You don't want to go all the way up to white because that will look a little bit weird, but just slightly, and that will help with the shadow. And then for the base color, you can set this to be whatever color theme that you want. So if you have like a scene that has a lot of orange or a lot of reds, you can set that to be over here. Or in this case, since we have like a little bit of blue lighting, I might set the particle color to be a little bit of a blue color, something like that. All right, so there we go. That is basically it for this tutorial. Now you can use this technique in any render that you have. For example, the DNA scene that we created in the last tutorial. All you would have to do is select both the cube and the icosphere, hit Control C, and then go over to your other blend file, and then hit Control V to paste in those objects. Scale up the object a little bit and then position it so where you can see it in the camera view. You might need to add a little bit more particles to the cube depending on the size of your scene. And then also make sure you turn off show emitter in the particle system to hide the cube so you don't see it in the render. You will still see the particles though, so don't worry. After you've done all that, your scene will look something like this. Now before we end this tutorial, let's do a quick render for our scene. I'm gonna turn on the volumetrics and set the tile size to be 4 pixels, just so that the volume is a little bit better. And then I'll turn on volumetric shadows. Also in the color management, I'm just gonna give this a little bit more contrast. We'll go medium contrast, just like there. And then I'll just go up to render and click on render image. All right, and there we go. We have dust particles floating in the air. So that's gonna be it for this tutorial. Thank you for watching. And like I said, you can use this technique in any of your scenes to really give a cool effect. Thanks again for watching. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe for more tutorials, and I'll see you guys in the next one.